Technology is just evolving so much. It's crazy at this point.
I don't like that. I mean, not to say I always trust myself and like those, you know, those gut judgments that you make in that type of situation, but I certainly am not at the point where I can trust my car.
Especially when you're, I mean, forced to hit maybe an animal.
Right.
Sometimes that is the better choice than just swerving off the road. But
judgment does play a factor into it. So, wow, very interesting. All right, well, I hope you buckled your seatbelt because we're in for
a hot ride
as we head through the rest of the week. A nice look outside right now. Beautiful conditions early on this morning, 53 degrees up in McCall. We're at 50 in Sun Valley. Nice sunny skies starting to, well, show their face off a little bit as the sun starts to show hints of coming up here shortly. Out over Boise, we're at 73. We're out at the airport and here at our studios downtown. Winds about 7 miles an hour. This via the train depot through the disaster cleanup camera network. Temperatures 40s and 50s in the mountains, 60s and 70s around here. Very mild. We're going to be in the mid 60s to low 70s these next several mornings, I think, with the scorching temperatures we're going to be dealing with in the afternoon. 68 in Mountain Home, and behind this is a satellite radar, but nothing really to show you there. Very few clouds in the picture for us at all this morning. The water vapor imagery gives us a pretty good idea of what's happening. We have high pressure kind of sitting here, rotating around this Four Corners region of the country. Drier, warmer air in the southwest, and because of that, it's also pushing it up in our direction, the jet stream or our storm track, taking everything well to the north of us, meaning we're just going to sit here and really kind of let those temperatures just cook, and it's going to continue to heat up ever so slightly as we head into the weekend, which means even warmer temperatures are on the way than what we're dealing with out there today. Dry and hot across much of the western region. The heat is not just for here. It is just about everywhere you go out. And as we head east a little ways, if you're traveling or know people traveling home from their 4th of July celebrations, could run into a little bit of severe weather as you look toward the south central plains here. Some severe storms, a nice line of them on the Texas-Oklahoma border, stretching into parts of the nation's midsection. So we'll be keeping an eye on those. Otherwise, just a little bit of scattered shower activity there in the parts of the Midwest. Our highs soaring back up to the triple digits and even above that 100 degree mark for many spots in southwest Idaho. Really 101 to 103 is kind of the range we're looking at. 102 in Mountain Home. Boise will be sitting at 101. 90s in the mountains, 90 degrees on the dot in McCall, and 93 in the Sun Valley area this afternoon. So it's going to be smoking hot. 101 for our forecasted high puts us about 11 degrees above where we belong this time of the year. We are usually at 89 in our record high, 106 set back in 1896. So no records for us today. That could change though as we get towards Saturday. Our temperatures are taking aim at that record high of 103 for Saturday, so we're going to come very close to it. At least right now, looking like we could tie that record, and there is the potential to shatter it. So we'll stay a little bit off here for the next several days, but beyond that, we could see the potential for record-breaking highs. Cooling off just a touch into early next week, but we'll get to that in a second. Your Live After 5 forecast, if you're headed out tonight, we'll be about 100 degrees at 5 o'clock, or daytime high 101. Staying in the upper 90s, I think, through most of that event, and then we'll cool off, if you can call it that, to 90 degrees by 9 p.m. So count on the 90s for anything you're out doing out there this evening. Skies will stay relatively clear for us. Could see a few passing clouds here and there in southwestern Idaho and our lower valleys today and tomorrow. The one thing we are going to watch for is increased cloud cover at times and the potential for a couple spotty heat-fueled thunderstorms in the mountains that would come mostly in the afternoons and evenings over the next several days, mostly through Saturday. And it's actually because of some monsoonal moisture that's hanging out down in the desert southwest. It's just going to provide enough instability out there to maybe trigger a heat fueled storm because of how hot it is. Not much changes in the 7 day. We actually just get a tad bit warmer as we head into Friday and Saturday. We could hit 103. That'll be the hottest in our string of triple digits, which hopefully should come to a halt by Sunday. And then early next week, we'll drop back off below 100 into the upper 90s.